I got a granddaughter who likes dressing up too. Cute as a button. She loves Peter Pan. She's always asking this old timer to read it to her. She's sharp as a tack. Full of ideas, questions about the Lost Boys and those pirates. Probably because I never grow old. She says to me, "Grandpa, are you old?" I said, "Yes, sweetheart, I'm old, and one day you're gonna be as old as me." And this gets her brains all cooking, and she says, "Well, Grandpa, are you gonna die?" And I say, "Yes, sweetheart, of course I'm gonna die one day. Well, it's not gonna be today." Finally, she says to me, "Grandpa, am I gonna die?" Well, how do you explain a question like that to a kid? So when Halloween rolls around the next year, there she is, proud as punch, she stands up and she goes, "Grandpa, I'm gonna be a pirate."
Happening to me. For months now, I've been having these dreams. Nightmares. But I think they were messages.
It's your grandmother's? There's a place up north. I think we can find you answers there.
Where are we going?
Back to where it all began.
I need to know the truth.
Or are we the prey?
She'd never be our enemy by choice. I know that. But what if it's not her choice?
A necklace? That's a locust symbol.
I want it out of my head. I want it to stop.
Katie?
Mom!
Samurai. You are a warrior. I can see that. You trained your whole life for this. And you have won battles that lesser men have called unwinnable, yes? But while you were sharpening your sword, do you know how I prepared for today? I learned. I know your language. Your traditions. Your beliefs. Which villages to tame and which to burn. So I'll ask you once again, Samurai. Do you surrender?
Jin, you're late.
You're impatient. Where's the monk?
The bastards beat me to him. Now they're torturing him at the temple.
Come on.
You think the monk's a hero?
We need him, Masako. Down.
We could take them.
No. Remember Sago Bridge? We strike quietly. And they kill the monk.
I'll guard the exits. Just get that monk.
Please, I do not understand.
Uldathwi, Chamagotun Hami, Uthmi Cheyavensakt, Chiobelatno. Timi Horia.
For every useful piece of land, to preserve ourselves from the terrors of the night and the horrors of the day.
I know not who can hear my voice. I shall therefore speak a word unto here. Anyone who dares to steal food will be hanged, and their bodies will be exposed.
Every day we rise from dust to choose between bad and worse. Choices we take to survive will create the world to come.
You know the drill. Get to the nearest safe house and wait until dawn. Good night, and good luck.
Dying Light 2 features a functioning ecosystem that reacts on multiple levels to the things you do and the choices you make. In the example we're about to show you, our protagonist undertakes a mission for the Peacekeepers, one of the many factions active in the city. They want you to negotiate with two survivors who are controlling and hoarding a water supply.
Are you going to insult us with another final offer?
Let's say you choose to carry out the Peacekeepers' orders, one way or another. After this, you'll start seeing a significant change in the city, as access to the water supply has allowed the Peacekeepers to bring stability and develop the area. There's even running water for the people at street level. And that raises their morale and allows you to replenish your energy on the go. But there's a cost to this. The PKs have a rigid approach to law and order. So while the streets may be safer, it's only safe for those who side with them. So if you get on their bad side... Now let's return to that moment of choice. And instead of killing them, you choose to team up with this group to supply water in the black market. As you will see, this creates a very different set of consequences for the city. With water being a precious currency, it brings you access to new resources and trade. But this in turn attracts the worst type of people to the area. And this is just a single decision, one out of hundreds you'll have to make. But it allows you to carve out your own world, your own city from the apocalypse. Each player's game experience will be unique. And by the way, this is just what happens in the day. At night, well, things tend to get a lot darker.
Once there was an explosion, a bang which gave birth to time and space. Once there was an explosion, a bang which set a planet spinning in that space. Once there was an explosion, a bang which gave rise to life as we know it. And then came the next explosion.
They know what's coming. They always know what's coming. Yes, you're ready. All right. Well, you know what? I know the answer to the question, but you ready to see him in action? Let's rock.
Motherfucker!
Ethan!
Never paid any heed to the ancient prophecies. Like fools, we clung to the old hatreds and fought as we had for generations. Day the sky rained fire, and a new enemy came among us. Stand now upon the brink of destruction, for the reign of chaos has come at last.
too late. This entire city must be purged.